It's Trixie, and I am back tonight. And I am going to be playing the Dead by Daylight Hooked on You game and Stream Raiders. And I thought, I got this game last summer, and I did try it just a couple of times, and then I was just so busy last summer, I really didn't get time to play it much. So I want to start it over again and see what happens. And then I'm gonna do that for a while and then eventually move over to DVD. So let's see what happens when we get into this. Because so we're gonna do new game. Look at Huntress. Wow. Oh my gosh. I don't remember much about it at all. I know it was rather outrageous. New file. What shall we call you? Trixie, of course. Okay, there's not enough room for Trixie Bella, so just Trixie. Oh, and we've got to get, if it gets to Trixie. Cough, cough, cough. All right, now. So we're set up on that. We're going to change over to Stream Raiders really quickly. And we need to place a War Beast, Vampires, and Bombers. Hi, Brad. I'm hooked on a feeling. I've been in love with you. All right, so we need to get through this battle. We never got through this one. Ace, how are you? I'm gonna be playing DVD, but after I get through this. Can't say but hugs. Aw, well, hugs to you too, Ace. I wanted to play this for a little while before I actually get into the game. I started it last summer and I never really got far into it. Steve! I got Steve! Steve and Brad and Ace are in the house. Right, I got my War Beast up. I'm putting my lurk message, and then we're gonna see what we've got more in this game. Oh, you. Are. Every single time. Her. Oh. There we go. And thanks for helping out. I forgot that part. All right. The Stream Raiders is ready. So that will move that out of the way till it is time. All right, and move this back to the game. All right, so we've got Trixie. Oh, I guess I need my controller back. That would be also helpful. Oh, I forgot to put, don't show my mouse. I gotta make sure I move that out of the way each time. You wake up on the beach soaking wet, salt water singing the inside of your throat as if you'd nearly drowned. Water falls from your mouth as you open it to gasp for air. Oh, it happens. You have no memory of how you got here. In fact, you can only remember your own name, but not where you came from or a single fact about your life. Will the other one work? Will the other shadow work? Okay. Oh, because there's an E in gaming. That's why. You gotta take the E out. Let's try this way. It does not exist. Probably because he's gone already. But yeah, there was an extra E in it. I think that's why. All right. It'll help if I click back on this screen. What you do know is that despite the outrageous beauty of the landscape around you, you feel incredibly sick to your stomach. Wow, really went down the wrong pipe, huh? You need a minute, or can I go on? Because I can give you a minute. We've got plenty of time. Endless time, really. Ocean. An eternity, if you catch my drift. Whoa, not now, Ocean. Sorry, Trixie. May I continue? Please, go on. Okay, then. As I was saying, you look down at your feet, ankle deep in the crystal blue water of a newly arrived wave. As the water recedes back into the ocean, it reveals a grotesque discovery. Ew! A decomposing face stares up at you from beneath the sand. All you can do is vomit. A stream of dark bile bugs forms another ick. Questions race through your mind. Where are you? How did you get here? Who is behind this incredibly charming and well-spoken voice in your head? However, answers don't come easy. Your mind is completely blank. What will you do? Run, close your eyes, or dig up that face! You turn away from this wretched sight and begin to run, but the beach is endless. Despite how far you run, you get nowhere. Exhausted. There you go. Now it worked. Thanks, we. Exhausted, you stop and look behind you. Your footsteps erased by soft blue waves. You turn inland. Considering your lack of options, you've got no choice but to walk into the brush. However, the beauty of the beach is not shared by the darkness of the palmy woods before you. There's nothing inviting about that shadowy forest. Terror freezes you in your steps. Ocean. Why are you trying to run away? This is paradise. You're here to enjoy yourself, don't you know? Have a little bit of fun. Take charge of your own experience. Well, that was sure weird. That voice again. Do oceans normally talk? Your memory isn't right, but you're pretty sure you remember learning as a child that oceans do not speak directly to people in spooky terms. Your mind doesn't have a chance to linger any longer on your current situation as you feel something soft bump into your foot. When you look down, you find a volleyball sitting in the sand there next to you. You stare down, frozen. A voice calls out from behind you. The Huntress. Little help, please. You turn around, and when you see what's waiting for you, your jaws just about hits the ground. Well then. Hello. Howdy doody. Whoa.
Oh,
Hi, Gord. How Four gorgeous monsters stand halfway between you and a well-tended volleyball court. Four. I never thought I'd read that. Four gorgeous monsters. Wilson, yes, it's Wilson. Each of them oozes with undead energy, a magical aura reaching out and penetrating you via your eyes. Your heart begins to race. Curiosity, fear, desire. You can't help but stare at these casually dressed, let's call them killers. I don't know, not to be judgmental, but that's just the energy they put out there. So many competing feelings rush through your mind at once that you're completely paralyzed. Holy muscles, Batman, that's right. The Trapper. Hello? There are weird days, and then there's this. All you can do is look down at the ball and back up at this monstrous lineup of, well, literal monsters. Sexy ass monsters, though. What do you do? Toss it back, kick it back, say no thanks, say nothing, do nothing. Toss it back. You bend down and grab the ball. It's warm from sitting in the sand on this beautiful day. When you give the ball a toss, it arcs beautifully through the air and lands right in Huntress's hands. Huntress, not bad, stranger. Huntress's muscles ripple as she grips it in her hand. You look her up and down and consider what it might be like to be held tightly in those strong arms. Warm, perhaps. Maybe a little sweaty. But that's okay. It's natural. The spirit. Try hard much? Blah. O. M. G. This is funny. You're speaking directly to you, but you still can't bring yourself to reply. You're entranced. When you snap out of it, you realize that everyone has gone back to the volleyball court. Alone again, you look across the beach at these strange residents who casually bat a volleyball back and forth, happily ignoring your intrusion onto their private beach. Should you be frightened? Worried? Excited? I did refer to them as killers, not to give too much away. Yes, I am, but this is not me in the game. This is somebody else named Trixie. It's a game! It's been silliness. Jeez Louise. But at the same time, this is more for everybody's entertainment. My god. But at the same time, damn, they are looking very appealing in their own way, and nobody so much as lifted a blood-soaked finger in your direction. Ocean. Don't be scared, Trixie. You were made for this. Well, geez, if the spooky ocean voice says not to be scared, I'm sure it's all going to work out. Yes, you guys can. Just pretend you're Trixie. With no good reason not to, you decide to head over and see what happens next. It seems like you've derailed the volleyball game just by showing up. That's me. Or you. Oh no. Trapper, you derailed the game just by showing up, nitwit. And I guess you're also a nitwit. Look, it's best to just go with what Trapper says when he says it. That's a policy I hold for pretty much anyone who always seems to have fresh blood on their hands. Spirit. Hey, don't worry about it. It's all just a game. Existence, that is. Spirit is very pretty. You guys are hilarious. Huntress. Besides, you seem a lot more interesting than a silly game. Oh, what's your deal? What brings you here? You mean they're here to do more than distract from my total domination? Wraith. That was Wraith. That sigh means he was done with the game, too. Either that, or he saw a butterfly or something. Look, I don't care why this slack-jawed moron is here. I just want to know, can I kill them or not? You know you can't. At least not yet. Oh yeah, not yet. Hey Trixie, you might want to know, say something. Actually, never mind. There'll be plenty of time for that soon enough. Right now, this group has some questions for you. Oh, Wraith has got some abs, I'm just saying. Okay, they've got questions for me. Oh, answer quickly and answer well. Well, dang, I was gonna have you guys help me answer, but if I have to answer quickly, I can't do that, so I have to do it fast. All right, answer quickly and answer well. This is a timed quiz, and it will be very important later. Oh no. Very important. Or not important in any way whatsoever. Probably that one. I can't remember. How attractive would you say you are? Very. I say I'm very attractive. That's what you think very attractive is compared to this? Trevor flexes, his muscles are so tight you can practically see the blood running through his veins. If you could have any superpower, what would it be? Invisibility, flight, super strength, invisibility. Invisibility? Same, although sometimes I think I already am. What is your best subject in school? Yeah, history. Probably math. That's the only thing that makes sense when you think about it. What's your favorite animal? Dog. I don't know what a muscle is. Definitely a cat. What? Why is everyone looking at me? You think just because I'm a typical cute goth girl, I have some specific love of all things cats, and more specifically black cats? Well, I do, but you can all go to hell anyway. What's your favorite color? Blue. Blue isn't good for productivity. Makes people want to be lazy. What's your dream job? There. If we get to do what we really want, why work at all? It takes a lot of courage to break free from society's expectations to climb the ladder. Only she could spin laziness into some kind of grand crusade. These damn millennials. Best flavor of ice cream. Horse flesh? Ooh. My favorite flavor is pain. Same. Same here. Mine is vanilla, swirled with pain. I think mint chip is the greatest flavor ever conceived myself. But enough about ice cream. Am I right? Hold on a second. This reminds me. I am right, always. It's a lesson you should learn before we go too much further. Do what I say if you want to survive. Pick mint chip. Ocean. We're teaching lessons now, narrator. You rascal. Kill or be killed is the rule on this island, even for faceless voices. Tell me, what's the best flavor of ice cream? The best flavor is mint chip. So obedient. I think you're gonna do just fine. Anywho, now that they know so much about you, I'm sure the group wants you to start getting to know them. I say for this pineapple. Favorite color is gray, all 50 shades of it. You guys are hilarious. They're gonna make you scream. All right, they want. I'm Trapper. I pretty much run things around here. I'm the smartest, richest, strongest person on this whole island. I don't like losers. If you want to know what a loser is, say hello to Wraith. Hi, I'm Wraith. I'm nothing like everyone else. I like nice people and loathe big dumb idiots. Hey, what's up? I'm spirit. I don't like most things. I don't really hate most things either. It's not worth my time. But the things I do hate, I really hate. You know? Based on my personal observations, life is nothing but suffering, and society is a carefully calculated lie to keep everyone subservient to those in power, instead of just not take part. Jeez, it's like she was downright murdered by society. She hates this so much. Oh, no, wait. I'm remembering Spirit's story now, and that's almost exactly what happened. Hey, I'm Huntress. Don't let these bummers get you down. There's lots of fun to be had on this island, along with lots of love. Yeah, there is, if you know what I mean. Grow up. Grow a body. I've explained this 1,000 times. I'm dead, but I'm not a literal ghost. I just create a trail of fog. I'm not made of it. Whatever, fog body. That's not nice. He's not nice. You love it. Only sometimes. Ew, really? That's disgusting. That's why she likes it. Don't speak for me. I also hate it. Stop speaking entirely, actually. For the first time ever, I agree with Wraith. Let's move on. Otherwise, they'll do this all day. Besides, if I know this crew, and I do, they'll want to show off soon enough. Hi, Coop. Might have to main. Oh my gosh. If we're done playing, let's do something else instead. Wow, for once, I actually agree with the meathead. I say we go to my yacht. It's the massive boat docked nearby. I'll give everyone a taste of true luxury and power. Wraith rolls his eyes. Don't mind him. He just hates fun and happiness. No, I hate the endless, desperate, soul-crushing pursuit of wealth, the way it's wanted needlessly, and the cruelty it engenders. What about hanging out by the pool? I find the water calming. Simple. Beautiful. Hey, what about our volleyball game? We can exercise and have some fun as a group. Are you all serious? There's a perfectly good lounge to chill out at right here. I'm tired, and besides, I hate being in the sun. Where do you want to go? It'd be great to relax for a second at the lounge. To kick up your feet, look out over the ocean, and relax on your own terms. Who would want anything else? Dry, comfortable, enjoying a cool drink on a hot day. It's the best. I mean, what kind of a fool? What kind of a monster? What kind of a mask-wearing psychopath would finally be granted a break from the constant grind of chasing and fighting to get ahead, and then chose to exert themselves in, quite frankly, any way whatsoever? That's because you have friends. That's right, and you have friends. Why am I the only one who gets it? It's time to stop living by their rules. I won't do it any longer. Yeah, we should probably give her a second to calm down. Hold on. For just one moment. This is Dwight and Claudette, our activities coordinators. They're also the cooks, waiters, bartenders, janitors, and every other job. They're the only help remaining on the island. This place we call Murderer's Island. Cue dramatic musical flourish. None of the others survived. survived the interview process, I mean. Hence why we shall heretofore refer to them as survivors, with a capital S. These two have worked here a long time. So very long. I don't actually know how long it's been. Sorry. Anyway, I should probably let Dwight and Claudette do their mandated jobs. They sure look happy, but they're vibrating with a nervous energy that is starting to give me the creeps. We will now escort the group to the venue of your choosing. However, in the future, we recommend waiting for us to present you with your options whenever possible. And don't just run off to various activities unsupervised. We don't have much autonomy around here. They've killed Meg. They've killed everybody. Apparently. Take a sip of my coffee. Yep. The least you can do is allow us to do our job. The most you can do is help us get off this island. Dwight? Yes, pardon me. Please, follow us. Hey, narrator. Yes, something I can help you with. Those two. Claudette and Dwight. Did they just start to mention something about wanting to escape? Is escape an option? Should I be trying to escape? Escape? Them? Oh, no, 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 no. I think you're mistaken. It seemed like Dwight was asking for help to get off this island, though. Oh, right, that, yes. That's true, he was. But he just meant that he wants to get to the other vacation island getaway, a couple miles south of here. It has much fancier accommodations than this island. It's one of those big corporate outfits, quite exclusive, where all the famous celebrities hang out. Very luxurious. Doesn't quite have the charm that this island has, though. Trust me, you wouldn't want to go there. With all that money comes a lot of restrictions. This is where you belong. Now, now, off you go. It's time for an activity. On this island, your decisions matter mostly. When I agree with them. Not like that other island. So what'll it be? Mwahahahahaha. Yes, you can't. I'm a Barbie girl in the Barbie world. Life in plastic, it's fantastic. You can brush my hair. You have to admit, she's pretty hot. Finally, freedom from the preposterous premise that the four of us would be engaged in some sort of thrilling 2-on-2 volleyball match. Spirit looks at you from beneath her gigantic sun hat. She takes a conspiratorial tone. I don't know whose idea volleyball was in the first place, but I hate them. I tried to feign a sprained ankle, but everyone already knows that I technically float above the ground, so nobody believed that I was even putting any pressure on my joints in the first place. Then I tried to annoy everyone by not giving a crap, and when that didn't work, I tried whining, and then when that didn't work, I threatened to kill every single person on this island. But so the music really makes a sense. And the crowd puts us in a trance. It's not distraction, I'll just go right back to it. Look! Her boobs are hanging out. We got it. Now we have Coop distracted with boobas. We got the beat. Bear's hot. Look at that slice in her leg, though. You can see it right down to her bone on her leg. I mean, look at that. She's got like a 2-inch gap of meat missing out of her leg. Yes, and the one in her arm. Both arms, actually. There's one in both arms. Wow. So she says, I threatened to kill every single person on this island. But it turns out I'm not the first to toss those kinds of threats around on this island. Hi, Yodel. Hi, Hex. So, thanks, I guess, for getting it called off. Aw, look, she's smiling and happy now. Are we threatening to end each other again? Now it's Dwight who takes on a conspiratorial tone, his eyes shifting as he slips into a loud whisper. Please, just make it quick. Is this what you'll be saying when we get behind the bar to make you the drink of your dreams? Hilarious, right, Dwight? Yeah, right. So, what will you be having? On a day like today, I could use something strong. Scotch on the rocks. Kalida, and of course, a very expensive looking bottle of top shelf liquor and horseshoe glass. Do enjoy. Who are you gonna choose for your date, Trixie? I don't know. Who would drink that? It smells like kerosene. I only picked it because it was the strongest sounding thing on the list. You need to embrace the burning. The burning? Oh yeah. All right, we got Stream Raiders. And let me bring this over here, change scenes. So we're gonna put a pause on this for a moment. And let's do this battle. Hey, Coop. I can see my thing. Here we go. Look, Coop. Happy now, Coop? All right. So we win. And Brad, you got the Shinobi trolls. And now we go here. And I need to put down. Oh crud! I can't even remember. Bombers and vampires. Yeah. Where is my? Are you? Alchemist bomber. Come on. There we go. I like the background sounds, they're kind of funny. All the bar noises. That up. close enough. Alright, next battle, half an hour. Kate! Kate's putting units on the field too. And Yodel and Brad. Alright, change the scene back. Alright, so we got another half hour of this, and then we'll be changing over to. You don't want to chop the ghosts as a bay? I don't want to chop the board at all! Alright, so, oh yeah! Can you hear it? Oh yeah! Oh yeah! It would help if I clicked on this screen so it actually worked. Why would you embrace that? Burning is! Thank you for treating! And hydrating, I gotta get the drink here. Phil? There we go. Okay. Why would you embrace that? Burning is... Wraith stifles a sob. No, I can't even think about it. Well then don't. No skin off my back, you weirdo. Come to think of it, strong, expensive, better the longer you leave it locked in the basement. Scotch is the best. Trapper guzzles half the bottle and burps. It'd be disgusting if it wasn't so. No, disgusting is exactly what it is. Since we've fulfilled your requests, it's time for you to return the favor. I should have known there was a catch. Icebreaker time! I swear, had I known they'd pull this kind of faux enthusiastic community building crap, I'd have suggested we attempt to walk to the lowest point of the ocean before I ever set foot near this bar. You don't think it could be kind of fun? A little fun? Never mind, I hate it. This sucks. But it could be fine, or whatever you say. Has anyone seen my hat? I've literally never seen him in a hat. If we must make small talk, I'm at least picking a topic before we end up being forced to do some lame improv game that nerds learn at their non-sports after-school activities that I definitely never did because I'm no nerd. Methinks a certain someone doth protest too much. Sitting here on this beautiful sunny afternoon, warm sand beneath the cool fog beneath my severed feet. The topic I choose is books, novels, comics, fiction, or non. Reading is the only real escape from the inescapable horror of life, the escape into your own mind. Where's my pants? I gotta go. A groan rolls through the crowd. Not a lot of readers here, I'd imagine, based on that response. They were much more enthusiastic about drinking. Considering the situation we're in, it seems an appropriate time to ask you. Trixie, what's your desert island book? The one book you'd bring with you if you were, well... on an island like this. Oh, and it has to be classic horror for reasons that should be obvious. She means because this is an island of horror villains. And also, those books are all in the public domain. Nothing too modern. Humanity has really gotten soft these past 100 years. So what's your favorite? Dracula is one classic that's so scary. Seduced by some beautiful stranger, only to learn later on that they're an immortal villain. It's downright thrilling? Well, I guess, but I was going to say that despite the deviant behavior of Dracula and the threat of possible danger or even death that he poses, you can't help but get turned on by the liberation from the status quo that he represents. Same here. So what if some old doctor says he's a bad boy? You're supposed to reek like garlic and sleep alone? Who did they think would buy into that? We're going to be trapped in the nightmare that is undead life eternal, which I know a little something about. He could do a lot worse than great clothes, a castle, and a lover who doesn't take shit from anyone. The scariest part of Dracula is thinking that no one will ever be quite as interesting to make love to as a vampire. Well. Enough about these old stories that belong to someone else. I think it's time to make up some new stories of our own. Look at her outfit. Before you know what's going on, Huntress is waving an empty vodka bottle in the air, a devilish twinkle in her half-mask covered eye. Yes, it did get a little windy in here. Might I suggest something a little naughty? Let's all get in a circle and spin this bad boy. Great idea. Oh my god. Great idea. Trickster, isn't it a bit late to introduce a new character? I thought I was the one who gets to make the rules, so I'm not sure who I'm asking. But I wasn't ready for this. Yeah, I think Trickster might have just turned the tables on that. Well, hello. And who is this new fan in the waiting? With his little laugh that he does. Beat it, hack. I don't know. What's the harm in inviting one more person to join the circle for our game? Oh, I can't say. I was just saying it's a great idea, while also teasing the secret trickster ending. I've got much, much better things to do than hang out here. I'm famous. Toodaloo! The rules are simple. First you spin, then you swap spit, that is. Let's be clear. This ain't a peep show. We're here to have a good time, but in a classy way. We're gonna do it the classy way, folks. Yes, he did. All makeouts will happen out of view of the public eye. Real romantic-like. Yes, romance is the goal, so I'll be waiting here in complete silence, trying to listen in and use our imaginations while you make out on the other side of the bar, but not watching. Like adults, romantic, well-adjusted adults. Trixie, you're up. Oh, yay. You grip the bottle in your hand and put your fate in the hands of the empty bottle gods. The empty bottle gods. Mini games consist of two parts. On top a pointer, which rotates in a clockwise direction. And on the bottom, a target you're going to be pointing at. Okay. This here upcoming minigame is a special minigame. Perfect for the less coordinated because there's no winning or losing. Okay. Well, not technically. Wherever the pointer stops, that's your result. I suppose if it doesn't stop where you want it to, that's a bit like losing, but no one has to know if you don't tell them. Okay, ready to play, or would you like me to repeat that? Ready. Away we go. Spin the bottle and see who you're gonna smooch. I don't wanna smooch somebody. Oh my god. It was on the line! You got Huntress. You two are meant to be. Like, you actually have to spin multiple times to get your real result. First to get to three times is your true match. That's how we play hardcore spin the bottle on this here island. Now get your spin on. You got spirit. Okay. Right? But this is not real me. This is a video game. Some other alternate personality. Oh no. Just this morning, you're waking up on a strange beach surrounded by strangers with murderous intent. Now you're looking across the beach to a huntress. Lust in her eyes, sweat glistening on her skin. Gonna smush me to death with her muscles. Your heart races, you can feel your pulse pounding in your ears. Huntress takes you by the hand and you sit face to face at a private section of the bar. She begins to reach for you, putting her hands on your shoulders. You're sweating, but not in the sexy way she is. You're sweating in the gross way you'd sweat at the interview for a job you're not even remotely qualified for. You don't know what to do. If you try and lock lips in this state, you might gross her out so completely that she'll never be able to look at you romantically again. Huntress, I'm sorry, but I can't kiss you right now. What? You're relieved, but also maybe a little hurt? It's not you. Well, it is you, but in a good way. I think you're great. Maybe too great. I don't trust easily, and I'm afraid of what it might mean to connect with you so early. It's not that I don't want to. I just don't think it's the right thing right now. I understand. Amazing. Also understand this. If you tell anyone I got soft, I'll break you in half. Okay? I'll tell them you almost chewed my whole face clean off. Ooh, I like that. I hate to break up such a passionate moment that we only assume was passionate because we'd never spy on you constantly while you stay on the island. But dinner is being served right away and we must insist that you join us. So they only had one time for one spin of the bottle. I am Groot. She could probably crush a car with her thighs. Who wouldn't want anyone dying of starvation? When there are so many more interesting things to die from. Seems like the next activity is mealtime. How quaint. You're expecting what? Capture the flag? Do you know how complicated it is to run a game like that? Much more so than sitting and talking. You arrive at the cookout area to find an assortment of picnic tables scattered about. What were you expecting? Some kind of grand hall with a huge banquet table? This ain't some prestigious fantasy epic like you'd find on cable. Dwight and Claudette usher you to your seat, but there's very limited seating directly around you. And, oh, great. Terrific. It seems that everyone wants to sit next to you. Even better is that they don't want to sit next to certain other people either. To start, no one wants to sit next to Trapper. Meanwhile, he refuses to sit next to Wraith or Trickster. Oh yeah, Trickster's here. Surprised? Yeah, well, they don't call him Expected-ster. I'm sorry, even I get nervous around crowds of killers. And my whole shtick gets a little flustered. Hey there, you're looking good, Trixie. Real good. We literally can't let Huntress and Trapper sit together. No, seriously, their arms are too big. They can't fit at the table if they sit side by side. Look at this, we can't even fit everyone on screen at the same time. You probably think it was an error, but it's not. It was completely intentional. Let that be a lesson to you. Every error you think you see is a choice. Got that? Okay, Joy and Claudette are directing traffic. You sit on one side, the rest of them will sit opposite you. Don't you think it's funny how every time they show Dwight and Claudette, they're like almost always got their butts together like that? Huntress and Trapper can sit at the ends with their enormous sexy arms. Now that everyone is seated, we can begin dinner. Tonight's meal is prepared slowly and carefully with both love and hate for 12 hours over a spit. Hope you all enjoy. We really, really hope you do. Hey, you didn't actually tell us what you're serving. What are we eating? It's meat, seasoned with a specific number of special herbs and spices that we simply can't divulge. My favorite. Meat is good. Meat is murder. Which you know, considering what you've been up to. Who are you to get judgy now? I'm just sharing facts. And you need to murder something to eat its meat. So that's, like, technically true. Technically true is the best kind of true. Brad, you're funny. Okay, enough yapping. Let's eat. Hey, Trixie. You thinking what I'm thinking? Time to take over the world. Yes. Is it going to be a person on that spit, right? Or several parts of overlapping people, perhaps? I haven't seen many pigs wearing palm tree button-down prints, you know. When you look closely at the spit, you spot what definitely appears to be scraps of fabric sandwiched between some layers of meat. I think I might be sick. Is there anything else to eat? This took 12 hours. And we do literally everything on this island. Actually, there's one thing you're not doing today. You're not carving up this delectable meal. Wow, he's right for a change, because I am with my broad axe. It's the perfect tool for easily chopping anything in twain. First, who says twain? Sometimes I swear, it's like we're all from completely different historical eras. Second, I'll handle this with my cleaver. Fast, powerful, and clean. At least it's clean when the meat is cooked. No blood. You two and your ridiculous bicep swinging contest. Enough! Grow up! Obviously, my gorgeous katana is the only option. Obs. The hell it is! I'll show you both my katana and send you to actual hell if you'd like. Please stop. Please. I hate when we fight or talk or even when we look each other in the eye. I can do it. I have the skull of Azeroth. Great. Instead of slicing it up, you can club it to a second death. Hey, Trixie. I know this isn't what you want to eat, but hurry up and volunteer to carve up Felix. I mean, dinner. Otherwise, this will go on for hours. No hyperbole. They once argued over who had the most effective weapons for 72 straight hours.
Wow. Ben and Snap. Ben and Snap.
Yep, they Felix is on the, he's on the menu tonight, boys and girls. And it doesn't matter which one does it. When they're done, they will take even longer cleaning their weapon. All the while explaining the value in maintaining your tools. Despite being a bunch of cold-blooded killers, for some reason they're always terrified of tetanus. Why don't you just let me carve up dinner? Splendid idea. We'd hate for it to get cold. He hated when it got cold. Here's a machete, freshly sharpened. Mini games consist of two parts. Yeah. Sometimes it's hidden until the pointer arrives. Press the tail to land on the target and you will lose. Land on the start of the target area, not the end. All right, I will try. I will do my bestest. Ready? Oh God, this is gonna be terrible. Not bad. Oh, that was too soon. You missed completely. Yeah, I know. I can't do it. That was pretty good. I'd like to see what you could do with a less clumsy weapon. Yeah, I said it. Machetes are dumb. Dinner is finally served. For real. The sounds, especially coming from the mass killers while they eat, which involves lifting their mask and shoving food up behind them, are nasty. Spirit, meanwhile, doesn't even eat. She's the only one who seems to be really embracing being dead. They're all dead, right? This is obviously hell. I mean, ocean. Come on, we're still trying to be mysterious here. You think mystery comes easy? Claudette and Dwight aren't the only ones who've been working their asses off to make this night perfect. Well, at least they're lifting their masks. This is only 99% as disgusting as it could be if they just tried to mash stuff through there. Oh my god. Why aren't you hungry? Spirit, why aren't you hungry? The two best things about being dead is not having to eat. That's only one thing. Think about it, Trixie. Number two is no number two. One less thing to think about in the afterlife. Even if I wanted to eat, I have no idea what would actually follow. You might have noticed, but I'm mostly just a bunch of dismembered body parts floating in a spectral form. Do you see how deep this cut on my abdomen is? I don't think my digestive tract connects anymore. Between the food and the behavior of the group, this might be the worst meal in history. But even worse is they're staring at you. You're not eating. They don't like that. I think they want an explanation why. What do you want to tell them? Oh, you ever see a sissy seagull that big? I haven't. That's incredible. Anyway, what were we talking about? Lame, misdirect. Yeah, she's right, Trixie. Pretty lame. Own who you are. Never compromise. Didn't you wash up on this island with no memory of who you are and how you got here? Yes, you did. Poor thing. You have no idea the last time you ate a real meal, and you've been standing in the sun. But the seagull. Uh-oh. He just made a lot of good points. I swear, you're beginning to feel lightheaded. It waved at me. Maybe you need to eat to survive here. Either that or someone poisoned you. No way. You haven't eaten, so you can't be poisoned. Whatever the answer, you're clearly about to pass out. Ocean. Oh, hey, it's me again. Your friend, mentor, and guide. Narrator to the narrator. The ocean. Not sure how I feel about that characterization, but I'll allow it. I brought you here, and I might be the only one who can help you now. There's only one thing you must do to survive. You have to figure out why you're really here. No one can tell you, not unless you follow the right path, or at least a right path. There's too many of those to count. Hopefully you pick at least one of them. Because there are even more wrong paths. Many of them lead to your demise. Others lead to something even worse. Starting scenes over and having to fast forward back to where you were, am I right? For this place holds many secrets, even from itself. But the one that truly matters can only be learned if you answer the most important question. Why are you here? Why are you here? Answer that and you'll learn the truth. The ultimate truth. Vague, mysterious. I gotta give it up to this ocean character. That's some quality early game storytelling. You wake up to find Spirit holding your limp body, gingerly pouring cool water into your mouth. Don't you just love the ocean at night? I do. Staring out over the vast darkness of the ocean really validates the feelings inside me that we're all truly insignificant and the only thing worth pursuing is revenge. I have to wonder how could anyone believe anything else? You look out into the darkness of night and ponder her question. Mine? Well, it's a simple question. How could they? How could anyone not feel small and alone in the face of such massive nothingness? I used to feel that way. Small, unimportant, alone. But lately, I'm not so sure. I've started to feel different. I started to actually think that maybe this island is where I might meet someone special. You look at Spirit, who has turned from the ocean to look at you while you speak on this topic she's clearly so passionate about. A friend, perhaps something more. I don't know what this island has planned for me. Ha, a friend? Friends are just cowards who seek comfort in numbers. I had friends once, back before I was chopped into a bunch of pieces by my father. Friends aren't what's keeping me held together. I'm floating in a cloud of rage. Ugh, I was so dumb, so busy trying to please everyone, be the perfect student, the perfect employee, the perfect daughter. I didn't take care of myself. And now I'm all I've got. Worst of all, I got distracted from my true purpose, my destiny, the purpose that was sitting inside me my whole life. Oh my goodness, look at all those people on Stream Raiders. That's amazing. Okay, so this might sound a bit silly, but she looks around to see if there's anyone else on the beach. When she's convinced that it's only you two, she continues. There's a dragon that lives inside me. I've always known, but I've tried to ignore it. When I couldn't ignore it, I tried to push it down. I'm so stupid. You're not stupid. That sounds badass. Right? But I didn't let it out. And then I, you know, chop chop. And now that dragon is pretty much a one-track revenge beast. But enough about me. What's inside of you, stranger? No dragon, just fire. A raging inferno. In fact, begging to burn this whole place down if I let it out. Maybe I am the dragon. I'm sorry, but you're no dragon. And breathing fire, that's some hobbit-type nonsense. I'm a descendant of proud samurai. Our dragons are on a whole other level. Looks like there was only room for one dragon inside Spirit after all. Just as things are really heating up, you hear a flurry of footsteps behind you, and you quickly spin around to fend off whatever new danger has popped up on this strange island. Only to find a Swite and Claudette sprinting across the beach, clipboards in hand, which they're waving in the air above their heads. It's very important that we stick to the itinerary and attend each event as scheduled. Playing sick for cute flirt points was not a part of this evening's activities. All right, we got Stream Raiders. And let me get this over here. Wow, look at that. Here we go. One, go. Boom, 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 boom. Alright, and then I will figure out if this thing is auto-saving, or if I have to save, and then I'm going to switch over to regular DVD. Alright, we win! Nice. Alright, now we got the big guy. And what I say, I needed vampires. Ah. Alert. Almost there. Mm-hmm. I did. Alright, Streamwriters is ready. We've got the boss battle coming up in about 30 minutes. Alright. So now I have to get DVD, or well, Hooked on You first, because I have to figure out this. Yeah, Strictly slotted in for after campfire story time. At this rate, we'll be late. Playing sick? No, I was. No time for excuses. Well, there is, but that's scheduled for after what comes after the flirting. Go, go, go! Alright, so let's see. There's the gear here. Save. Are you going to overwrite the save file? Yes. Alright. 2214. That is correct. Alright, I'm going to put this on Stream Raiders while I close the game. Get Dead by Daylight up. Coop, are you here?